Shape layers are the backbone of motion graphics. In this video, we are going to go over 5 things you need to know about shape layers so that you can get started in creating some killer motion graphics. Let's get rolling. Number 1, shape layers are vector graphics. Without going into the technicalities of what a vector graphic is, Wikipedia exists if you're into that. In terms of motion graphics, what this means practically is that shape layers can be scaled up and down infinitely without losing detail. Number 2, let's go over the basic components of a shape layer. The path, the stroke, and the fill. These attributes are organized into groups on a shape layer. A shape layer can contain one or more shape groups found in the contents section. Thus, a single shape layer in the timeline can represent more than one shape in the composition. Each shape group has its own set of transform properties that can be modified independently from the transform properties of the shape layer itself. Multiple shape groups can be combined to create a new group. Each new group will then have its own set of transform properties that will modify all the shapes in that group. Number 3, there are 2 kinds of shape paths in After Effects. The first kind is called a parametric path. Parametric shape paths are created using the shape tools here. Each shape has its own unique parameters, hence the name parametric shapes. The only way to modify the shape and size of a parametric shape is to modify these numeric values in the timeline. The second kind of path is called a Bezier path. Bezier paths are created using the pen tool. A Bezier path consists of vertex points connected by segments. Each vertex point has handles that determine the interpolation of the segments between each point. Using the Convert Vertex tool, you can manipulate the position of the vertex points as well as the angle and length of the handles. The position of all the vertex points, as well as the angle and length of their handles, are stored in one path property. If you happen to click on a vertex point that has curved segments, but you don't see any handles, that is because your path is set to Roto Bezier. To convert it back to a manual Bezier for full control, right-click on any of the vertex points and uncheck Roto Bezier. Number 4. When you have a shape layer that contains a large number of shapes, navigating through all those different shape groups can become tedious, especially when you have groups within groups within groups. But there are a few tricks that make navigating through the different groups on a shape layer a lot easier. To demonstrate this, I'm going to use this illustration I downloaded from Envato Elements, this video's sponsor. This illustration is one of several business-themed illustrations I downloaded in this pack. In addition to illustrations like this, Envato Elements has a library of over 54,000 vector graphics that you can use in your personal and commercial projects. From icons and illustrations to textures and backgrounds, illustrations like this are perfect for using in explainer videos or web design or many other use cases. But it doesn't end there. Envato Elements gives you the access to unlimited downloads of stock video, After Effects templates, music, sound effects, a personal favorite, Photoshop templates, fonts, stock photos, PowerPoint presentations, and much, much more. Basically, it's just a massive library of everything and anything you need to make your creative projects stand out. I don't even know if any other service that offers a subscription like this offers unlimited downloads with licensing that is straightforward and easy to understand. Also, if you decide to pay annually instead of monthly, you get an additional 50% off the monthly subscription price, which ends up being less than 20 bucks a month. Just to give you an idea, Adobe stock subscription starts at 30 bucks for just 10 downloads a month, and that doesn't include access to their video or music libraries. Those have to be purchased separately. So if you are considering Envato Elements and you want to support the channel, consider following my link in the description below to sign up. So like I said, with a shape layer like this that has lots of different shape groups, it can be super tedious to have to twirl open all the different levels of shape groups. Luckily, there is an easier way of navigating through the different shape groups. I'll leave these shape groups open so that you can see what is happening as I navigate through the layer. The first most basic way to select a group is to double click on that group. Every time you double click, you will select the next group down in the hierarchy until you reach the bottom. Now, if I want to, for example, select the nose without having to double click 3 or 4 times to descend through the different groups, I can hold Control or Command on a Mac, which will change my cursor, and I can click on the shape I want to select directly. Now, with the shape selected, I can move it around. On a side note, if you want to move the shape, make sure you have the white cursor first. If you don't see the white cursor, move your cursor to the center of the shape. If you see the black cursor and try to move the shape, you will end up selecting one of the vertex points instead, messing up the shape. Now, let's take a step back and say I want to animate this head nodding, so I need to have access to the rotation properties of the head group to keyframe the rotation. So I'll select the man group by double clicking on the man and then double clicking on the head. With the head group selected, I can hit SS to isolate that group in my timeline. Then I can twirl open that group and navigate to the transform properties. And last but not least, number 5. If you want to add new shapes to an existing layer, just simply make sure that you have the shape layer you want to add to selected in the timeline before drawing your new shapes. Once you've added your new shapes, you can select them while holding Ctrl and Shift, and then group them by hitting Ctrl G. Then, with my new group selected, I can hit SS to solo that group in the timeline and rename it. If you want to add a new shape, but you want to add it on its own individual layer, just make sure to deselect any layers before you draw the new shape. If you have a layer selected that is not a shape layer, like footage layer or image layer, you will draw a mask on that layer instead of creating a new shape layer. New shape layers are only created when you have no other layers selected. Now, if you want to create a mask on a shape layer instead of a new shape group, just make sure that the mask setting is selected in the shape toolbar before you draw your shape. You only have to make this switch when you're wanting to mask a shape layer. I know I said 5 things, but I'm gonna give you 6 extra little things to know about shape layers so that you can really hit the ground running. Number 1, like I said, parametric paths can only be modified by changing the numeric values in the path parameters found on the timeline. Thus, the tool like the Convert Vertex tool cannot be used on parametric paths. However, you can convert a parametric path to a Bezier path, then use the Convert Vertex tool. To do that, right-click on the path in the timeline and select Convert to Bezier Path. However, once you've converted your parametric path to a Bezier path, it cannot be converted back to a parametric path. Same goes for Bezier paths created using the pen tool. That conversion is a one-way street. Number 2, if you want to skip the conversion process and create one of these shapes as a Bezier path directly, you can check this box up here on the timeline. Or, as you draw out your shape, hold Alt and you will draw the shape as a Bezier path. Number 3, even though the default properties of a shape path are the path, a stroke, and a fill, more properties can be added and rearranged within a group. You can have multiple strokes, each with their own color, for example, or you can even reverse the order of the stroke and the fill. Or you can have multiple gradient fills to create some crazy gradient patterns. Number 4, scaling the shape group will scale the stroke as well. However, scaling up a parametric shape using the shape path parameters will not affect the scale of the stroke. Number 5, since there are no size parameters for a Bezier path, if you want to scale up a Bezier path without affecting the scale of the stroke, you can select all the vertex points and then double click on one of them, which will give you a free transform bounding box you can then use to scale up the Bezier path. Doing so this way will not affect the scale of the stroke. Number 6, you can drag the stroke property outside of the group and place it underneath the group in the stack. Now you can use the scale of the group's transform properties without scaling up the stroke. Okay, so hopefully that gave you a basic understanding of shape layers. I know that when I first started in After Effects, the difference between parametric shapes and Bezier shapes was a little confusing, and I didn't really understand why sometimes I could use the convert vertex tool on one shape, or why I could grab points on one shape but I couldn't grab them on a rectangle or something like that. So hopefully I clarified that for you. Now, if you found that this tutorial was a little basic, make sure that you still are subscribed, because I work almost exclusively with shape layers in After Effects. So I have a lot of experience and I'm eager to share with you guys some of my techniques. So I'm gonna be doing more videos on more advanced techniques with shape layers. So make sure you're subscribed for that and the bell icon is turned on so that you're notified whenever I post a new video. If you found that this video was helpful, make sure you hit that like button. That helps me reach more people in the algorithm. So if you found that this video was helpful, hit that like button to share the love. Now, if you have ideas for more tutorials in the future in regards to shape layers, or if you have questions about shape layers, leave those comments in the comment section below. And thanks for watching, and we'll see you all in the next video.